Hey lovers, it's your girl Disastrous Beauty coming back with the voiceover. So this unit was sent to me by Eon Hair. Shout out to Eon for sending me this unit. Right here, I was just showing you guys what all came in the packaging. Now I am showing you guys the cap construction. This unit does come with 3 combs in the front, and yes sis, no comb in the back, okay? It does have adjustable straps. Right here, I'm just adhering the wig. This unit is a customizable color. I'm not sure of the exact color, but it is their 12-inch bob. The frontal is 13x6, and it is 150% density, and the texture of this unit is body wave. I don't have a lot of details and specs as far as the coloring and all that. All they had on there was customizable. If I do get it, I will have it down below in the description box, but I will also have a direct link to this wig in case you guys want to cop it. And yeah, y'all, that is pretty much it. I just wanted to get on here and say, hey girl, so hey girl, and I will see you love folks in the outro. Bye. Details, the specs, and all of that good stuff, then please continue to watch. So this unit was sent to me by Eon Hair. Shout out to you, Eon, for sending me this unit. This is yet another company. Pretty much all the companies that I've been working with are companies that I've always worked with, but Eon is really like one of those companies that I've been working with for a while, honey, okay? So I definitely swear by this company. So the unit that I am wearing is, they have on here, because this is all the information that I have. I don't have the information on my phone like I normally do. But the style, it says lace frontal wig, texture is a body wave bob. The length is 12 inches, it's 13x6. The density is 150%, and then it has transparent. So I'm assuming that they're saying that the lace is transparent because it definitely was. And the color is customized. So I don't actually know what color this is, okay? So it looks, it's really red, and they sent me a couple of pictures to pick from, and I ended up picking this one, and I was like reddish bob with the platinum streak. Like, so yes, y'all, I did pick this wig. The lace is definitely transparent. That can be a good thing, a bad thing. It just depends on you. Like, usually when they say transparent, it can come off pretty ashy. I think it looks pretty good. Like, usually when I get dyed wigs, I think that the lace looks really good. Now, y'all don't judge me. I do not have this frontal, I got to be glued. I don't have it adhered all the way across. It's just literally just the front part. Like, I'm acting like I'm wearing a closure. So, right here's the lace. And honestly, y'all, I think the lace looks pretty good. Like, it looks really good, actually. The hairline is a little dense. Like, not crazy dense, but it is a little dense. It does look like they did tweeze it some, but it could use some more tweezing. But I don't think it looks bad at all. And as far as shed and tangling, like, literally there was no tangling, there was no shedding. This unit did come with some curls, and as you guys saw, I did curl it some, but I will get more into details about that in my outro of this video. But yeah, like, there's no shedding, there's no tangling, and I think that the length is as stated. Now, as far as the cap size, let me just go on their site and see if they offer a small, medium, or large, or if that's just like their standard is medium. Hold on one moment. Okay, so it looks like it depends on the wig. Some wigs you can get something other than a medium. You can get a small or a large, but it looks like they charge like based on that. Now, I want to say, for me, y'all, this wig is bothering this lash. This lash looks like I got lazy eye. But it looks like they do charge if you get a small or a large. I personally feel like there's enough wiggle room with this wig that you can make a medium cap work, whether your head is small or large. Like, I feel like you can make it work. Like, I feel like it's big head friendly enough that you can make it work. And I feel like small head sizes can always make it work. You just really have to cut off a lot of lace, like around your ear portion. Like, just cut all that crap off, sis, okay? And adhere it and keep it moving. Now, it depends on the length of the wig, but especially for longer units, you can make it work, in my humble opinion, honey. Okay, so yeah, that is pretty much it as far as the specs, the details about this wig. I do want to also mention there is no comb in the back, sis, okay? We literally have 3 combs in the front and no comb in the back. I am super used to a comb being in the back. That really threw me off, but there is no comb in the back. So I want you guys to keep that in mind. Now I will get into my thoughts, opinions, and all that good stuff about this wig. So if you are interested in that, continue to watch. Okay, honey, I ain't gonna lie. When I first put old girl on, I was like, sis, I look like my name should be Cherry, okay? Like, I look like my name should be Cherry, okay? If you get it, you get it, okay? But I'm not gonna lie, after makeup, because this is another one of those wigs that you need some makeup on, sis, for it to look decent. After some makeup, I am now feeling the wig. What? Yes, y'all. I am now feeling her, and I have named her Cherry. Her name is Cherry, sis, okay? So it's a whole look to me. Now, I'm going to say, y'all, this is not for the faint of heart, okay? This is not for you, honey. This is not for she. This is for somebody that's looking to step outside their comfort zone, or maybe somebody just like colors in general, because this hair is really taking it there, honey. Okay, it is taking it there. And the issue with these type of wigs, you cannot wear a lot of colors. Like, I had to throw on the white turtleneck because it's not a lot of colors that are safe with this color hair. So keep that in mind. But y'all, I think it's a look. I like what they did there, honey. Okay, go Ia, go Ia, go Ia. I think it's a look. Now, you can part it how you want to. I did choose to part it on the right side. You can part it in the middle if you want to, and then you can have the 2 platinum pieces coming down the side. You can part it on your, I have it on my right side. You can part it on your left side. I normally just gravitate towards my left side. I don't know why, but I wasn't feeling that vibe with this week. I was feeling this vibe with this week. So I really don't actually have a side preference. Let me stop lying. Okay, I don't have a side preference, but I know some people do. So right now I have it parted on the right side, but you can part it wherever you want. This is a frontal wig. And yeah, like, I feel like the hairline is decent. You can tweeze it a little more and open it up, but I didn't feel like it was really going to be seen just because of the way I have it styled, like with that hump right there. And yeah, that is pretty much my thoughts on this wig. Now, as far as what I used on it, I did use my Original Freeze volumizing holding spray. I did use that, and I did obviously use my argan mousse, and then I used my curling iron, honey, okay? Because your girl can work curling iron. You know, I struggle with them doggone wand curlers, but I can work curling iron, okay? She can do a curling iron. But yeah, so I did go in with my curling iron and bumped it a little bit, but this hair did come with curls, so that is a plus. Even though it's a body wave unit, it felt like it had more curls in it than waves, honey. Okay, so I was feeling that for sure. Now, I didn't curl all in the back. I just kind of left that how it was. So if the back look a mess, child, worry about your own head. No, I'm just playing. The back looks worse. Looks bad. Don't judge me, sis, because I just didn't go back there because I felt like the curls were enough in the back that I didn't have to. And then I kind of, to get this effect in the front. You just kind of get you a wide tooth comb, comb it back like that, and then just let it fall, and it'll give you this effect. And that is pretty much it. So I'm going to give you guys a full 360, and we can wrap this thing all the way up. So this is obviously the unit in the front. This is it on the left side. This is it in the back. And this is it on the right side. Okay, so like I said, I'm feeling it surprisingly. I mean, I picked it out, but I don't know. When I put it on, I was like, who gonna put that on? But yeah, it definitely grew on me. So I would recommend it, especially if you looking for something a little different, you know. Honey, she's hot, okay? So if you are interested in this unit, I will have all the links, the details, the specs, all that good stuff about the wig down below in the description box, as well as a direct link to this wig and a direct link to the site in case you just want to check out Eon. I mean, you might know maybe this is not your cup of tea, but you can go and check out all the other wigs that they got, okay? You know, if they got something like this, then they definitely got the normal norms, okay? If they got this, they definitely got your regular degla smegla colors, okay? So if you are interested, definitely click the link down below. And yeah, that is pretty much it. So if you like this video, give me a thumbs up. If you have any questions, something you feel like I may have left out, feel free to comment down below. And if you're not already subscribed, sis, click the subscribe button. And if you're not already, follow me on all my social media platforms. I am Disastrous Beauty on both IG and Facebook. I'm Hell to Miss C on Snapchat, and I'm Disastrous B on Twitter. And I will see you love bugs next time. Bye.